Hi Shraddha.
Hello.
So today we are talking about the upcoming IPO. I think there are about 8 to 9 IPOs lined up in March 2021.
Yes.
And we have barely 8 to 9 trading session to go.
Yes.
So from an investor point of view, I want to understand, if I apply in these companies, will I be able to make money? Should I apply in all? What should I do? What should my strategy be?
Yeah, so all these eight companies are into different sectors. So if we talk about, take the two companies, EaseMetric and Nazara Technologies. So these are the one of its kind that is going to be listed in the Indian Stock Exchange. EaseMetric is into travel agency company that they have no listed pairs. And second is Nazara Technologies. It's into digital gaming company that one of its kind to be listed. All the other companies are there in US like Tencent, and electronic art.
Global peers.
So seeing that all these have created, you know, fantasy among the investors to apply for an IPO.
Especially, you know, we have seen this year itself that a lot of these gaming companies multiply 10 times, 20 times, and okay, again they simmer down.
Yeah.
So will we see similar action in Nazara?
So, but that time will say, of course. But India is a country where, you know, more than 50% of the population is younger at age, like below 30. So gaming is, you know, gaming is all time favorite of everyone. Like, it's the shift is there. We can see the shift from movies, entertainment zone, now online gaming is taking.
Plus this lockdown is also helping them.
Correct.
And I think the most important factor could be, I might be wrong, the entry of Reliance Jio and the faster internet speed that we have seen.
Correct.
That has actually given a boost to that, along with the pandemic and lockdown, has given a boost to this business segment.
Yeah, so all these, the gaming companies have come with the interaction sort of, you know, thing where people can also talk while playing.
So it is not like, you know, earlier you used to go and play alone on the computer. Now I think it has completely changed.
Yes.
It is like a battlefield. You go in the digital space and you pick up your opponent and start competing with him or her.
Along with making fun with each other, you know, talking and giggling around.
So, but from investor point of view, I mean, how has this company performed and what do you think going forward? Because I was also reading some of the details of Nazara. I think They have been in existence for some time, but they have done recently, I think mainly on account of the companies that they have acquired. So it looks like more like a M&A play than the gaming tech play.
Yeah, so inorganic thing, the growth has basically, because of the inorganic growth, you can say, they have invested around 200 odd crores in the investment. The recent investment was in NODWIN, where the company majorly looks at itself as a e-sport digital gaming company. So this has actually created fantasy. Like, if we go ahead, like in foreign companies, like in US, we have Tencent, Electronic Arts. They are in a position which has already built, you know, a bit better stage than in India.
So we can also assume that, you know, that some of the foreign companies, maybe of companies like Facebook or companies like Google, Sony, EA Arts, could be a good entry point for them into India if they come and acquire Nazara.
Yeah, but recently, management is into talks. Like, we cannot say right now that, you know, they are willing to be a takeover kind of thing, but We can see a turnaround in the gaming zone because of Nazara.
So Nazara is one, EaseMetric is second, yeah. And then
Lakshmi Organics and Anupam Rasayan, that they are into speciality chemicals.
And there is also Kalyan Jewel.
Kalyan Jewelers is the one such company which we are skeptical about how the IPO will turn around. Because of two reasons, the sector has already been a, you know.
So from an investor point of view, will it make sense for me to go and apply in Kalyan? Or I think the Titan still offers me a better perspective than the Kalyan Jewel, because Titan has an established track record.
Yeah, yeah. So if you see the financials of Kalyan, it's basically weaker, having a lot of, you know, debts in the books. And people always, look for the companies who have a better financial track record. So of course, valuation wise, although Kalyan is offering me 52 times P and Titan is, you know, running around 85 sort of P. But definitely, always, you know, the companies which offers a good valuation.
So investor also looks from a safety point of view. What is the margin of safety between, if I have to choose between Nazara, between Titan and Kalyan Jewelers?
Yeah, so people will of course go for Titan because of the management and you know, track records. And though in that case, valuation doesn't make sense.
So from an investor point of view, it is very exciting time. You know, market is so high at 50,000. I mean, that is a separate topic altogether. That what is the valuation? But from an investor point, it looks very exciting for me to go and apply in these companies and let market decide how they should be valued.
Yeah, we are looking that all these companies should.
Out of this, out 8 companies, should I apply in all or should I be selective? Where the companies?
You should be selective. Like MTAR was a good one. Then you know some special, even Anupam Rasayan is a good one. Then you can see for Nazara, it's a good one. You should you know, because it's a bull phase, you should apply for the IPO. Look for.
But we should do our due diligence and consult our financial advisor before going ahead.
Correct.
Okay. Thank you for your time, Shraddha. Thank you.